Hi, my name is Evie Kuppe. I'm assistant professor in the Faculty of Technology, Policy and Management. In this lecture, we will broaden the scope of value-sensitive design. We will go into the role of the institutional context in which technology is being developed and implemented. This is important because values are not only embedded in a technology, but also in the institutional context. My focus is on technological projects with a spatial impact. Think of infrastructural projects such as the construction of roads and dikes, or of energy projects such as wind farms or natural gas production. Many of those projects have had to deal with public acceptance issues. Publics have opposed to the construction of railways, transmission lines, carbon capture and storage projects, waste facilities, etc. One of the claims of responsible innovation is that if these projects are designed in such a way that they are more acceptable, so sensitive to the values at stake, this will increase public support for such projects. However, value-sensitive design of technology only will never be sufficient to develop projects that are acceptable or accepted. This has to do with the fact that besides the so-called substantive values, so values that relate to the technology itself, such as safety or efficiency, there are also procedural values that determine the acceptability of a technology. Procedural values refer to the way decisions are being taken and projects executed. Literature in the field of science and technology studies shows how responses to new technologies are largely determined by the process through which publics are informed and involved. This means that the acceptability of a new energy project is determined not only by the characteristics of the technology, but also by the characteristics of the decision-making procedure. This refers to values such as transparency, fairness, and procedural justice. The importance of procedural values suggests that value-sensitive design for responsible innovation requires a broader scope than design of only technology. Values are not only present in technology, but also in institutions. Therefore, it makes sense to extend the scope beyond technology and include institutions as well. With institutions, I mean the rules of the game that can both constrain and enable behavior. Institutions can be formal and informal. Formal institutions are, for instance, laws, standards, regulations, and contracts. Informal institutions are, for example, customs, traditions, and routines. Both formal and informal institutions embody certain values. This is most obvious for formal institutions. For example, law prescribes project developers to conduct an environmental impact assessment of their planned project. This should safeguard the value of environmental health and safety. It's interesting to note that in controversies, often institutions such as an environmental impact become contested themselves. People, for instance, don't agree with the scope of the assessment. By focusing on a particular set of values, environmental health and safety in this case, these are prioritized in the decision-making process at the expense of others. This shows how values embedded in institutions are intertwined with the acceptability of technologies. The informal institutions are perhaps less tangible, but they equally embody certain values. Routines, for example, represent ways of doing things that, by their repeated enactment, don't require much mental effort. And this makes efficient behavior possible. But the downside of routines is that they implicitly favor particular values to others. The use of jargon is an example in this case. The repeated use of particular words or abbreviations may turn into a very efficient jargon that facilitates communication with peers. However, it also functions as a mechanism that excludes people who are unfamiliar with the jargon. And of course, this is something that may hamper the involvement of publics in decision making. The risk is that particular public values are not represented. So if you want to design for values, this means that you should not only think about the design of technology, but also about how institutions can be designed or redesigned in order to accommodate divergent values. It's the task of the analyst to identify the values that are embedded in the formal and informal institutions, as well as the potential conflicts between these values. And this implies the study of a broad empirical domain. legal frameworks at different territorial levels, but also strategies, cultures and routines in a variety of segments of civil society, industry and policy. The institutional context is not static nor fixed, but it changes over time and place. And this means that the acceptability, or what is perceived as acceptable, also changes over time, and it depends on the context in which technology is developed and implemented. For instance, in the Netherlands, the value of flood safety is being reformulated as a reaction to both changes in the perceived threat and the degree of acceptance of high dikes as the primary means of protection. And this suggests that neither values nor the way they are being translated can be taken for granted. No, values emerge and they transform during the development and implementation of technology. So, if you want to design for values, this means, firstly, that you cannot rely on only ex ante assessment of relevant values. Rather, it requires ongoing and continuous assessment of public values in order to make sure that also emergent values can be accounted for. Secondly, it means that a design can only be value sensitive when it is adapted to the context at hand in terms of space, time, culture, etc. There is no such thing as a blueprint value sensitive design of a particular technology. If you want to design for values, this means you have to go out and talk to people in order to find out what the technology means to them, how it affects them, what is at stake for them, how they want to be involved or not, etc. So it requires the use of social science methods. So far, I've talked about the public and its values. But in order to understand how value-sensitive design comes about, it's important to consider the values and beliefs of the technology developer or policymaker as well. This is because we know that the way publics respond to technology depends on the way technology developers or policymakers communicate with them. I will give an example. A label that project developers often use to describe public opposition to new technologies is that of NIMBY, not in my backyard. The NIMBY label claims that people oppose to new technologies because they put their own private, short-term interest, for example, a quiet living environment, before the collective long-term interests, for example, secure energy supply. And this is strongly linked to the deeply rooted belief that the public is ill-informed and risk-averse. And such beliefs shape how project developers interact with publics. So, if a project developer thinks that someone is ill-informed, he will probably focus in his communication on providing technical facts and explain the safety of the project. Yet, actually, as we saw earlier, the public may be more concerned about procedural issues, such as fairness, transparency, or the distribution of costs and benefits. And these concerns are not addressed by providing more information on technology and risk. And this mismatch frustrates the process, leading to the paradox that efforts to prevent opposition by providing the hard facts may actually provoke public opposition. Design for values thus means that you need to think about and reflect upon your own beliefs and values in order to investigate how these steer interaction with other stakeholders. This reflexivity is necessary to understand and accept that there is a diversity of values and problem definitions at stake in case of technology. So, wrapping up, by now, it should be clear that value-sensitive design is about more than technologies. It is about design and redesign of institutions as well. These institutions cover both formal institutions, such as law and regulation, as well as informal institutions, such as routines, practices, ways of doing things, and even deeply rooted beliefs, such as beliefs on what the role of the public is in technology development. My talk can be summarized with the four conclusions for value-sensitive design. Value-sensitive design is about technology and institutions. Secondly, value-sensitive design requires ongoing and continuous assessment of public values. Thirdly, it should be specified to specific contexts, so spatial context, time and cultural context. And lastly, it requires reflexivity of the designer and technology developer. Thank you very much.